ball, a mat, and a medium set of weights for biceps, so front of the arm. We have 6 exercises, 1 minute each. You're going to work through the circuit. Try to work through the circuit 3 times for me. You and I are going to work together once. You'll repeat it 2 more times after that. Don't forget the warm-up that's on YouTube, and then finish the workout off with the cool-down, also on YouTube. So to start with, we are standing up. You need your weight. We have a lunge with our foot on the ball, 1 foot on the floor, and I'd like your weight. If you need help, you can go to the wall to help for balance, and you'll just do your bicep curl with 1 arm, and then around on the other leg, we'll do the other arm. Alright, so we have 1 minute. Here we go. Weight's going to be in that heel. We're going to bend through your knees over your heels, shoulder over hips, palms forward, curl. So, as we go down, weights go down, body goes down. As we come up, weights curl up. Inhale and exhale. I really want you to push through the heel of that front foot. I want your shoulder blades pulled back. I want your knee in line with your heel. And the ball is rolling a little bit forward and a little bit back. We're fighting to have that ball roll back in a straight line and then back up in a straight line. You also might feel a bit of a stretch in this bottom position. Are you hanging out for a second? Keep going on that back hip. Really fighting for a weighted heel on the front. That's going to protect your knees. Shoulders over hips, shoulder blades pulled back. Big strong curl. We're almost there. Down and up. Good. You're going to switch legs for me. So, exercise 2. Opposite leg. Now we're going to hammer curl. Palms are going to face in. So, we have 1 minute here. Here we go. We're going to sit back into it. Weights in my heel, knee over heel, and then we curl up. Pattern is the same. We just have palms facing in, working front of the arm in a different way. So, we have our biceps with our palms forward. Exercise 1. Now we're working a hammer curl. Biceps in a different way for exercise 2. Still working through glutes and legs. On that front leg, again, maybe getting a bit of a stretch on that back leg, fighting for balance. You might have more balance on one side than on the other. Shoulders down away from ears, shoulder blades pulled back, chest is out, and I'm really fighting to keep my upper arm nice and still, elbows by side. Should start feeling this through the front of your arm now. Keep going for me, we're checking our timer. We have 2 and last 1. Good. Weights get to go out of the way for me. Exercise 3. Standing behind the ball. Standing roll up. So, you might have seen this before with me. Hips are over our heels. Knees are bent a tiny little bit. Here we go. Hands are on the ball. You're going to roll your weight onto the ball. Hands are right underneath your shoulders. Little weight as possible on our feet. We're going to try to roll that ball up from under us. We're keeping our weight on our hands. We pull back. You come back to rest. Now, if you can, if you've been working out with me for a while, you stay in that forward lean. So the weight is on the ball the whole time. We do not release that contraction onto our hands. If your wrist gets sore, by all means, shift back. Weight on the heels, take a break, stretch your wrist, come on back up. Trick is on this, to keep the weight on the ball. Do not transfer your weight back onto your feet as you roll your hands out from under you. Tummy is nice and tight. We have a nice strong back. You're actively pushing away from the ball. We have 1 more. You can rest every now and then. You can rest every single time. Good, come on all the way back. All right, forward ball roll. So standing roll out, forward ball roll. Still working through tummy and abs. Hands start on the ball, shoulders down away from ears. I like toes tucked, whatever makes you happy. We're gonna roll that ball out. Shoulders, hips, and knees, nice straight line. We're gonna roll that ball back in. Head is in neutral. Shoulders down away from ears. Fingers are nice and relaxed. If back is nice and strong, you don't feel any pressure in your low back, you can start to roll that ball a little bit further. further. So more advanced position is rolling out, shoulders, hips, knees, nice straight line, slow control back. You can see I'm in a controlled pattern. I have a bit of a hold in that out position and then a strong roll back. Fingers are relaxed the whole time. Hips are up just slightly. I don't want any pressure in that low back. Last one here. Inhale and exhale. Good. I'm going to pivot so we can put the ball to the wall if you need to. If you're more advanced, ball's going to be away from wall. We're into plank with a leg straight out to the side. So, elbows into the ball. Let's start our timer. I'm sure you want me to do that. Elbows into the ball. Shoulders, hips, feet, nice straight line. We're going abduction with our leg, which means we're going to put all our weight on one side, light little tap out, back to the middle. Alternating sides, light little tap out, back to the middle. As I tap from side to side, I'm fighting to keep the ball nice and still, and I'm fighting to keep my hips nice and level. So as I go up to the side, I don't want to see your hips dropping. Tummy in nice and tight, elbows strong under shoulders. If you need to, place that ball up against a wall. That'll make this a little bit easier for you. Fingers are relaxed. Shoulders are down away from ears. I'm lightly tapping. I'm controlling that leg out to the side. Toes point down. Hips stay pointed forward. Knees down towards the floor. So I'm not rotating through my core or my torso. Last one, and good. Now, from here, we are going plank jacks. So, big breath in, at the wall will make this easier. Open, close, open, close. We are down on our elbows to keep our wrists nice and relaxed. If you need to, we tap, 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 and tap. Just a little bit quicker pace than we were just doing. And when you're ready, you can come back to a hop. In and out, fighting to keep that ball nice and still. More advanced position, pull the ball away from the wall. We have 20 seconds left. Open and close. Inhale, exhale. Heart rate should be going up. 10 seconds left. So keep that pace with me. 7 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Really good work. Okay, so you have that cool down. If this is round one, two more times. If it's round three, hop to that cool down. I'll see you next time. Good work.